Do all of them get a help from the government?
Some of them have SSI or SSD, Social Security, and others have get help from DSS who might pay their rent once we find them housing or they get food stamps. Some of them won't go to DSS, so they don't get anything. They just kind of panhandle, on the streets or collect bottles like yours. Or some of them just do stay here and they don't do because we give them 3 meals a day. They have everything they need right here. So I'm trying to help break that cycle because I don't think it's good. You know what I mean? That you just do everything for somebody, and they don't do anything. So that just creates more depression and more,
But let's see, if you always provide for them, but you don't give them the way to make that living themselves, that means they're going to be dependent on somebody for life. How long can someone be here?
As long as they need to be here. As long as they like we've had some people that's been here for probably 15 years.
15 years?
So somebody who is very mentally ill, won't take their medication, they've been kicked out of every other shelter, and they're not here like constantly. So some people they'll come in for a few months and they leave, then they come back and stay for, they get kicked out of somewhere else and they come back. And that's that compassion part. But some of the younger guys that are around here, and I told Sister Grace that they're different from when she, 35 years ago when she first started, They're more violent, they're using harder drugs that's making that K2 that's making them really out of their mind. So their judgment is off. So, that's why I try to get the younger ones connected somewhere else really quick because most of them don't last around here because they don't want you to tell them what to do. They want you to help them, but they don't want you to tell them how to help them. You know what I mean? They just want to give me, give me, give me. I need, I need, I need. So, but it's a good program. I think it's something that's needed in our community. If we weren't here, where would all these people go? We've absorbed a lot of the people that came from Rochester Psychiatric Center when they closed down. So a lot of people that live here or come around here, if the psych center had been open, they would qualify to be in the psych center. But we have them, some of them here.
Why did they close it down?
Finances, the government cutting back, cutbacks.